This is the SNF SVG Coder Training Tape. The SVG Coder is an automated track system for dispensing photoresist on 4-inch silicon, glass, or quartz wafers. The system includes two stations, a prime oven, which bakes the wafer and dispenses the adhesion promoter HMDS, and a combination spinner, which dispenses photoresist, and pre-bake oven, which cures the resist. The uniformity of spun photoresist is typically plus or minus 100 angstroms. We have two tracks, track 1 in the front and track 2 in the back. At track 1, we have Shipley 3612 for standard 1 micron or 1.6 micron resist thickness and SPR 220-7 for standard 7 micron or 10 micron resist or thicker films. SPR 220-3 for standard 3 micron bump to the machine. Manual resist spinning is allowed for e-beam resist applications using only PMMA 2%, PMMA 5%, and UVN 30. At track 2, we have Shipley 3612 for standard 1 micron or 1.6 resist thickness. For eyeline, SPR 955 CM.7 for 0.7 to 1 micron. There's no manual resist dispense on track 2 allowed. For polyamide, LOL 2000, PMMA 950K 9%, or ZEP, please use the headway coder. To give a brief overview, both tracks have cassette loading, HMDS vapor prime, cooling stations, resist coat, and bake and cool stations. Please make no SVG coat reservations. If no one is using the system, enable SVG coat for the front track or SVG coat 2 for the back track. Before coating, check the photoresist waste containers under the tracks. Open the metal door. You'll find two waste containers attached to the system. If the front waste container is half full, press and hold the track 1 button on the chemical delivery unit in the upper right corner to pump the waste into the large waste container inside the flammable cabinet. If the waste container in the back is half full, press and hold the track 2 button on the chemical delivery unit. If you don't empty the waste containers, the waste container alarm will go on and the track will shut down. Silence the alarm, empty the waste container, switch the alarm back, and continue working. If the large waste container goes on, shut down the system on call and contact maintenance. Carefully close the metal door. Go to the flammable cabinet to the right of the coder. On the top shelf, HMDS containers for track 1 and track 2. On the center shelf, EBR for track 1, track 2, and a resist waste container. There are 6 bottles of resist on the bottom shelf. Check the amount of resist in the bottle you'd like to use, and change the resist bottle if there's only 1 inch of resist left in the bottle. How to change the resist bottle? Find the appropriate resist bottle in the flammable cabinet. Use only a new bottle if available. If you can't find a bottle, contact the stockroom. Transfer the resist only in a metal cart, never hand carry chemicals. Place a full bottle on the floor. Carefully take out the empty bottle and place it next to the full bottle. Open both bottles. And then exchange the caps. Change the name tag, and then place the full bottle in the cabinet. Return the used bottle to the flammable cabinet in the service area. It can be used for manual resist spinning at the Laurel or the Headway. You'll find the standard program for each track on the left side of the machine. Check the selected programs are correct to use. On the table, you'll find a list of each event step for all the standard programs. You'll find program numbers for prime, coat, and bake stations. Use SVG Coat Track 1 or SVG Coat Track 2 sheet to check each event. At this track, only metal cassettes are allowed. There's an H-bar at the bottom. Watch out for the white stopper. Place an empty cassette at the unload station. If the cassette is down, push Index Reset button to raise it up. If a cassette is already present, tilt it for reset, otherwise the machine will not know it's there and will not move wafers from the cool plate to the cassette. Close the plastic doors to prevent fumes from getting into the lab, and please notify the staff immediately if resist smells are detected while working at the station. Make sure the system is in auto mode. For this training, we're going to run a 4-inch silicon wafer at track 1, running the standard HMDS prime program number 1, the resist coat program number 7 for 1 micron resist thickness, and a 2mm edge removal, and bake program number 1, 60 seconds at 90 degrees C. Before you run your process wafers, you should always run dummy wafers. Place wafers in a metal cassette, front side facing up. Verify that the back side of your wafer is resist free. This wafer has resist on one side. Notice the edge bead removal. Place a cassette on the load station. The first wafer will be the bottom wafer. Then press start. The hot plate temperature is set to 125 degrees C. Do not change the temperature. The priming agent, HMDS, promotes resist adhesion on oxide wafer surfaces. Once primed, the oxide layer becomes hydrophobic. It repels water vapor. If you do not need the prime station, choose a program with the first event end. HMDS is widely used in the semiconductor industry to improve photoresist adhesion to oxides. The HMDS reacts with the oxide surface in a process known as saliation, forming a strong bond to the surface. At the same time, free bonds are left which react readily with the photoresist, enhancing the photoresist adhesion. The wafer is then transported to the cool station, and then onto the coat station. The wafer is now ready to be coated with photoresist. The wafer is held on a vacuum chuck and then spun at high speed to reduce a thin, uniform layer. The thickness of the resist depends on the viscosity of the resist and is controlled by the spin speed and time. Photoresist is a light-sensitive material similar to the coating on regular photography film. Exposure to light changes the chemical structure from non-soluble to soluble. An edge bead develops along the wafer edge during the spinning process. Depending on your process, you may run a program with or without edge bead removal. For example, if the resist is going to be used in the STS dry RIE etcher, run a program without EBR. After the resist coating is complete, the wafer is transported from the spinner station to the soft bake station. Bake is set at 90 degrees C. Do not change the temperature. The hot plate bakes the wafer by direct convection at 90 degrees C. This baking step removes most of the remaining solvents in the resist layer and improves the resist adhesion to the underlying material. Never put wafers resist side down on the hot plate. If you like to coat both sides of your wafer, either coat them in manual mode using only the coater station or select a program number on the prime and bake stations that has the first event end. This will bypass these stations in auto mode. The wafer is then transported to the cooling station. And then onto the receiving cassette. Once all wafers have been processed and have been loaded into the receiving cassette, press. The cassette will move up. You can then remove the cassette from the receiving station. Place your wafers in your transport box and the dummy wafers in the dummy wafer box. Clean up the area and disable SVG coat or SVG coat 2 on coral. Did you enable the correct track? If the alarm sounds on the track, press clear, then locate the problem and correct it. Look for turning belts. If belts are turning, someone's removed a wafer before completion of the process. Take a dummy wafer and place it on the turning belts. Remove it and resume your run. If the utility alarm sounds on the upper left corner panel, switch the audible alarm off, locate the problem, correct it, and then switch the switch back to the audible alarm on position. In an emergency like an earthquake or fire, press the red emergency stop button located on the left side of the HMDS keypad for track 1. Please don't push one of the power buttons on the keypad. Contact maintenance if you need assistance. This concludes the SVG Coder training tape. Thank you for watching.
And I-line resist SPR 955 CM 0.7 for 0.71 micron.